Hi, it's Jordantine One, and in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to make my new Lumigurumi soccer ball. So I think it's pretty cool. The one I'm doing in the tutorial is the black and white, and then the one here on the left, I did rainbow colors. I just took the white sections and changed every few rows to make the colors of the rainbow, and I think it turned out really cool. And I think the neat thing about the black and white one is when you make it, sometimes when you stare at it, the white sections really come through. And then other times you'll look at it and the black sections come through, that it looks like more like a black ball with a white design, and then other times white ball with a black design. So I think that's kind of cool about it. And it's made with two halves, and then you stitch the two pieces together. To make your soccer ball, you're going to need a hook of some sort. I have the Rainbow Loom metal hook, but you can use a crochet hook or whatever you have on hand. You're going to need something for the stuffing, so I'm using polyfill. And then in the tutorial, you'll see me use a twist tie to help me get my magic ring started, or if you have the Loomy Loom, you can use that. And both of those are optional, but they are very helpful. And then you're going to need some clips or stitch markers. And then as far as the band counts, I used 372 black and 488 white. I'm going to begin by making a magic ring of five, so I have my six black rubber bands. I have a twist tie to help me get my magic ring started. And if you wanted to use the Loomy Loom, you would use the one that has the five fins. So I'm going to put the twist tie right next to my hook, take my first band and triple it, so it goes on, twist, back on, twist, and back on. You'll have your three loops, pull this up, bend it in half, and all this twist tie is doing is helping hold these three loops together and just giving you something to grab onto. So if you didn't have that, you just had your plain hook, you would just use your fingers to pinch those three loops. So I'm going to pull through my first band, get it back on my hook. I have the two loops, one through the other, back through from the front, push through those three loops, pull through my second band. I have three loops this time, one through the other two. Let me just take this out. I see my paper is tearing. I think this twist tie has met its end. So I'm just going to continue to push through those three loops. Here's number three, four, and five. So then I'm going to just take my clip or stitch marker, put it on the band that's on my hook. Spread these around the circle as best as I can. I want them evenly spaced. And then if you count your stitches, that's the little sideways V on the outer edge of your magic ring. You have one, two, three, four, and then number five is on your hook. In row two, you'll need 10 black, and we're doing an increase in every stitch. So I'm going to push under my first stitch, make sure you're going under both loops, pull through the first band, get it back on your hook, three loops, one through the other two. And then you're going to go back through that same stitch a second time, and then that was our first increase. Move over to the second stitch, again, everyone's going to get an increase, so there's the first band, back through the same stitch for the second, and then just continue to repeat. So this is going to be our first pentagon that's going to be at the top of the ball. So all of the black are going to be pentagons with the five sides, and then all of the white are hexagons with the six sides. So here's my last stitch where the clip is. And then I'm just going to move that to the band that's on my hook. In row 3, we'll be using 15 black, and it's going to be an increase followed by a single, and that pattern's going to repeat 5 times. So we're starting with that increase. So there's 1, and back through the same stitch for my second. And then we have a single in the second stitch. And an increase in the third. We're just going to continue to repeat that the whole way around. So this is the last row that we're going to be doing that's all black. And then we're going to start to add the white. So we're going to be doing a whole lot of slip stitches, which are pretty easy to do. The hardest part is knowing which little sections to ignore when you're going into a slip stitch when you've gotten to the next row. So here's my last increase. It's on the second to last stitch. And then one single. In row 4, the pattern is an increase followed by 2 singles, and the first band of each increase is going to be black. So I'm going in my first stitch and I'm pulling through a black band. And then I'm going back through that same stitch for my increase. This time I'm switching to the white, so I do want to do a slip stitch. And so I'm pulling through the stitch, also through the other band on my hook. Get the other end back on, so I have just the 2 white and 1 through the other. And then it's going to be 2 white singles. So they're just regular single crochets. And then we're next to the increase. So, slip stitch, pull through everything on your hook, you'll have just the 2 black, and then back through the same, and another slip stitch with the white. Again, we have 2 white. So this is just going to build out that pentagon shape with the 5 sides. We have the black, so slip stitch, back through the same, another slip stitch with the white, and then the 2 white. And then we're on to our increase. So slip stitch with the black, back through, slip stitch with the white, and then the 2 singles. And then one more time, so slip stitch, back through, white through everything, and then that leaves us with 2 white. In row 5, we're increasing to 25 bands, so it's that increase with a black and white, and then it's going to be followed by 3 white singles. So now that we've done slip stitches on the previous row, you're going to notice that it looks a little bit different, and you have to be careful that you're going in the correct spot. So our first one here was a slip stitch, the black, so you can see it may look like 2 black stitches. One is going to be more vertical, sticking up and down, and the other one is going to be more horizontal. So you want to go under the horizontal part, that's the true stitch. And it's always going to be the one that's farther over to the left. So I'm ignoring this first part, going over to the next. It's going to be an increase. So I'm doing a slip stitch with the black, and then back through that same stitch, I'm doing the slip stitch with the white. And then our next stitch over, you can see, was a slip stitch in the previous row. So again, you have this first part that sticks more up and down. You're ignoring that, going under the stitch, and we're doing three white singles. So that's 1, 2, 3. And then we're just going to keep repeating that pattern. So the black is a slip stitch. See the part that's sticking up, ignore that, go over to the left. We're going to do a slip stitch with the black, back through the same stitch, slip stitch with the white. Next one over, again, this is not the true stitch, it's the next part over. Again, we have three of the white singles. So they are just going to be that regular single crochet. Again, black was a slip stitch, ignore, go over to the left, go under both of those loops, slip stitch with a black, back through, and a slip stitch with a white. Again, ignore. Now we're on to the three regular white. So this part's pretty straightforward. Just really need to watch out for those slip stitches. And I will remind you for the first couple rows. So ignore, doing our increase. So pull through everything with the black, back through, pull through everything with the white. Ignore. And we're on to our three white. Slip stitch, so ignore. Switching to black. Back through the black stitch. Pull through it all, switching to white. Ignore. And then we have our final three white. Whoops, I just lost my clip there. In row 6, we're increasing to 30 bands. It's an increase with the black and the white, followed by 4 white. With the exception of the very last stitch, it's going to be black. So we're starting with a black, so ignore. Doing that slip stitch. Back through. White through everything. Ignore, and then this time we have the 4 white singles. So that's 1, 2, 3, and 4. That'll take you up to your next black stitch. So ignore. Black is always getting that increase. So slip stitch, back through. Slip stitch, whoops, didn't quite make it. Ignore, it's important to ignore that first part of the white. It's kind of a little bit harder to see there. It's a little bit hidden. We have our 4 white singles. Onto our third increase, so ignore. Push under both loops. Slip stitch with the black, back through, another slip stitch, ignore, and then we have our 4 white. So this is actually our last row of doing increases for a little while. We won't be doing any in the next few rows, although there will be some closer to the center. Now ignore. Black through all. Back through black. And slip with a white. Ignore. And then we have our four. And then the last set of the pattern, it changes just a little bit. So ignore doing that increase. So black through all, back through, then your white. Ignore. And this time we only have the three white, just because we want the pattern to line up and work out. And then in that very last stitch where your clip is, switching to black, you will have to do a slip stitch. And then just move your clip. And also what I like to do is just use my fingers and try and smooth this out. It's a little bit more bumpy where you do your slip stitches. So I just like to go around and sort of flatten and smooth this out. In row 7, we're doing one single crochet into each stitch, so the pattern is 5 white and 1 black. Our first stitch we're going under is black, so ignore the first part. Do a slip stitch with your white. Ignore. And we're doing 5 total, so that was 2, 3, 4, and 5. And now you will have 1 white stitch left, and you're going to do a black band. So do your slip stitch. Your next one is black, so ignore the first part. Switching to the white, so slip stitch, ignore, and then we have 2, 3, 4, and 5, and then once again, last white stitch is going to get a black. It's going to be that pattern every time. So slip stitch, ignore, black stitch gets the white band, slip stitch, ignore, and then we have 4 more. Last white stitch gets the black, so pull through everything, ignore, and then that black stitch is going to start your first white in the pattern. Slip stitch, ignore, my last white. Last white stitch gets a black. Slip stitch. Ignore. Switching to white. This is our last set of the pattern. Ignore. And now it is a white going under a white. That was the second to last stitch. And then ignore, last stitch. This time it is lining up. Slip stitch, and move your clip. In row 8, it's one single crochet into each stitch again. This time the pattern is 4 whites and 2 blacks. So I think I'm not going to continue to remind you about slip stitches. Just know that anytime you're changing color, you need to do one. And anytime there was one in the previous row, just skip the first part. So for example, the very first part here was a slip stitch, so make sure you're ignoring that. So I'm going to do the 4 white, so that's 1, 2, 3, 4, and now I have 1 white stitch left, switching to black, and then I have a second black. So we're just widening out those black pentagons, and then back to white. So again, there's 4, so that's 2, 3, 4, and again, just like in the previous row, your last white is going to be switching to black, and then you're going to do a black under a black. Back to white. Last white, switch to black. Second black. Repeat again. Again, last white gets a black, and then black gets a black. And then we have this pattern one final time. And then we're ending on 2 black. So as this starts to grow, it should definitely start seeing that soccer ball pattern. And again, when you do each row, you can just kind of run your fingers along and smooth that out. Row 9 is our last row of 30, and the pattern is 3 white followed by 3 black. So our first stitch is a white with a white band. And then we're going to do 2 more whites. And then we're switching to black. It's under a white stitch. And then there's going to be 2 more black, and they're going under black stitches. So basically we're just widening the black and narrowing the white. Onto the white, so there's my third, and then you're going to have that one white stitch left that we're changing to black, and then 2 more black that are lining up. Again, white stitch. We have our three white bands. And then last white starts the black. And then two more. White stitch, white band, two more, last white gets the black, and two more. So one more time, we have the white, last three stitches, switch to black, smooth that out. In row 10, we're increasing to 36 bands, and the majority of the row is black, with the exception of the very last band. It's going to be white. So the first stitch we're going under is white, and just remember about that slip stitch. We're starting out with just four black singles. And you already have black on your hook, so you don't have to do any slip stitch. So here's two, three, and then the next black stitch for number four. Now that's going to take you to the middle of this black pentagon, so that's going to get your increase. It's always going to be lining up in the center. And now we're going to be doing five black singles. So the first one is going under a black stitch. And then the next three are going under white stitches. The nice thing is, with it being all black like this, you don't have to be doing any slip stitches in this row. Just have to pay attention to your slip stitches from the previous. And now we have three black bands here, three black stitches. First one gets a single, and then the second one in the center gets your increase. And then we start the pattern all over again. So we have a black stitch with a black band, and then we have three whites. So that's number two, three, and four, and then black stitch, that's number five, and then in the center of those three black, that's your increase. Now we're repeating. So, one, and then we have two, three, four under white, number five under black, increase in the middle. We're going to repeat this one more time. So by doing all black in this row, we're closing off the shape, this white shape of the hexagon. It's like finishing the bottom of that. So second to last stitch, the middle here gets your increase. And then here's where it differs just a little bit, just to keep up the pattern. What we need to do is that increase in the very last stitch. So starting with a black, that's going to complete this part of the pentagon, but now we need to start the next hexagon in white. So you see it's a little bit of a larger gap there. So what I'm going to suggest is you go through an extra loop just so it's not such a large gap. Do your slip stitch and then add your clip. In row 11, it's one single crochet in each stitch, so we have 36 bands. So we're starting with two white. So we already have white on our hook, so it's just regular single crochets. And now we're switching to black. So we're going to be doing four black and three white for the majority of the row. Here's two. Three. Four. And then we have the three white. And if you look here, your white should be lining up. They should be totally in line with one another. Just starting our next hexagon. So that was the three, and now we have the four black. And then again, your three white should line up. Don't forget about your slip stitches. Again, four black. Oops, quite make it through there. So we're still widening out this pentagon. We're almost down to the base of it. Again, three white. Oops. And if you do feel like there's any large gaps, I know from doing a lot of slip stitches, sometimes you may feel like there's a little bit more of a gap in there. You can always just go under an extra loop. And that will just tighten that up. So wherever you feel that it's necessary. And now I have my whites. Here's my last set of black. And then finally we have the two white. So your second to last one is going under a black stitch, switching to the white, and then one more left. Let me just take out the clip. In row 12, we're doing some more increasing, so our stitch count is going to be 41. We're starting off with two white singles. They're both going under white stitches. We already have white on our hook. And then the pattern is going to be a black stitch with a black band. And then the second black stitch, we're doing an increase. And then the next black stitch, another black. And then you'll have one black stitch left, and we're switching to white. And then we're going to have a white stitch with white. And again, two more. Now we have the black stitch with a black band. So slip stitch. Increase in the second. And then another black single. So you're always going to have that one additional black band left. That's going to be switching to white. And then the rest are going to line up. So white's under white. First black. Increase in the second. One more black. Again, last black starts the white. So we have the four. Black stitch, increase, single, black stitch, white band. And one more time here, black band, or black stitch with black band. Then the increase. Single black. That's going to leave us with three white. So black stitch. And then the remaining two are white stitches. In row 13, you're going to need 40 bands, and we're doing one decrease. It's going to be in this last black section. So we're starting with two white singles, and they are going underneath white stitches. And then we're going to set up the pattern for the majority of the row. It's going to be three black. Again, these are going under black stitches, so they're lining up. and then 5 white. So the first white is always going to be under the black stitch. And then the remaining 4 are going to line up. And then we're back to the 3 black. Again, last black starts the white. And then they're going to line up. Again, black under black, we're going to do the 3. Black stitch with a white. So we are doing that decrease towards the end. If you remember back to row 10, we had to do an extra increase to get the pattern to line up. And that's the same thing we're doing here. We're just having to do that decrease again to make the colors stay in line and to make the pattern even. Again, black stitch with a white band. This is our last set of the 5 white. Slide these up here. And now we have black stitch with black. Here's where we're doing our decrease. So it's within the next 2 black stitches we want them to go together. I'm working just in the outer loop. And what I'm going to do is skip the first, go into the second. Again, push down through the middle, just that outer loop. Pull slightly back, and now you want to push through that first outer loop. So it should make like a little X on your hook. You're just going to pull your band straight through, and one through the other two. And then that leaves 1 black stitch. It's going to be a black band. And then 3 more whites. They are going to line up with white stitches. I think I made it under both loops. There we go. Row 14 is going to be the last row for one half of your ball, and for the other half we're going to create a row 15. So if this is the half that ends on 14, you're going to stop at the black. If this is the row that you're building out through row 15, you're going to need to go all the way to the end here with 40 bands. So we're starting with 1 single white. And then we have a black under a white stitch. We have 2 whites that are both going under black stitches. So these whites are basically closing off the end of the black, starting the next hexagon. We have a black under the last black, and then we have 4 whites, and these will all line up. So you'll see the main pattern is going to be 4 whites and a black, and then 2 whites and a black. It's going to just keep repeating. So last white gets a black, And now the two black both get white. Last black gets a black. And then we're on to the four white. So the hexagons are going to start to get smaller, and the black parts are getting closed off. So I have a black, and then under the black, the two whites, my next black, and then four whites. Again, white stitch with a black. Oops, I pulled it just a little bit too hard there. I lost the grip of my fingers. There we go. Now black stitches with white. Black with black. Next four white. And black under white. Two white under black. And let me just slide these up. We have our black under black. And now, as I said, if this is your half that is ending on row 14, you would stop here. You're actually stopping three short of the end because we don't want to build this white anymore. We want it to be the same as all the other whites. We want it to have the five rows. Now, if this is the half that you're building up row 15, you will have to continue on all the way to the end doing your other three. So let me just show that. And then if you haven't been doing it already, you'll need to go back to row one and make the second half of this, and then I will show you how to make row 15. So I will add the time to go back to. In row 15, we're going to use just 36 bands, so it's not going to go all the way to the end of the row, and the pattern is one black and three white. So we're starting under a white stitch with a black, and then it's going to be a black stitch with a white. So it's going to be repeating the entire way. It's not going to change this time. We have a white under a white. These do line up. And then black under black. Again, three whites, so they will line up at first. And then we have a white stitch with a black. A black stitch with a white. And then two more whites that are in line. So some of the times they're going to line up, and then every once in a while they don't. I have black under black, three whites under white, And then here comes the part where they don't match. I have black under white. And then white under black. Again, we have two more whites under white. Black under a black. And then three whites and then here's the mismatch, so black under white and white under black two more white black under black, and three more whites. I just forgot my slip stitch there. And one more time with the pattern. So black under white under black, and two more whites. So as I said, we're not going all the way back to the start. You're going to actually have four empty stitches. So I'm just going to take my clip and put it on the band that's around my hook. When you have your two sections formed, it's time to stitch the pieces together. So for that, you're going to need 10 black and 35 white. So your one half is going to be a little bit smaller because we only did the 14 rows. And remember, we didn't go all the way back to where the initial start of the row was. You should have ended on a black, and you should have not done the white in the very last section. And then on the other piece, we did 15 rows. And again, that did not go all the way back to the start. We did end on a white for that. So what I'm going to do is flip these inside out, and I'm going to line this up. So on the one half, this is the one that has the 14 rows. That is going to have a bigger section of the white hexagon, and then just that one single row starting the next section of the hexagon. And same thing on the lower piece here. You're going to have two rows, actually, because this had the extra row of white. That's just the little part, and then the almost formed section. So the way that you're going to line these up is going to be just like this. So we do have loose bands, one on either side, that you need to work in. It doesn't really matter where you have them. I think I will start on the one side. Start where the loose band is, and my other loose band I just have facing the other side. So I'm going to start with the black here. I'm going to take my hook, push through the black. I'm going to grab the black loose band, and then I'm just going to hold this in my fingers, and I'm going to push through the black stitch on the other side. Take a black band, it's going to pull through everything on my hook. Get the other end back on. I have just the two black and one through the other. So I'm going to work my way around here, and I will be going into some of the slip stitches. I know for the whole part when we were forming this, I said don't go in the slip stitches. And in order to get the colors to match up, we are going to have to. So whenever you're dealing with the fatter part of the hexagon that is mostly formed, you're going to ignore the slip stitch, and whatever's the smaller section, you're going to have to go in that slip stitch. So let me just show you. This first little white here was a slip stitch. So since this is the bigger section, we're ignoring that. And that leaves us with three actual stitches. But if you look to the top, we only have two white stitches. Therefore, we do need to use that slip stitch as a true stitch. So hopefully you understand that. So we're just going to go through the actual stitch on each section. Doing the white, it pulls through, back on. We're not doing slip stitches, just one through the other two. And then through the next one, that's actual stitches. And now we have one white left, but you can see at the top, this actually was a slip stitch. We're going to have to go through that. It's going to be a little bit tight to get through. But we really need to have that so that the colors match up. So now we have black in the next. And you're going to have like what looks like the two black because one part is a slip stitch. We're only going to go through one. Same thing with the top. This part over to the left is actually the slip stitch and that's the true stitch. They kind of are opposite. But you're only going through the actual stitch on the black. And now we're back to white. Now this is reversed. The larger chunk is on the top. So we are ignoring the slip stitch. It's all the way over to the left. But on the bottom, we only have three actual bands. So we are going to use the slip stitch. That's the very first part. Push through that and the stitch. And then we're going to do a total of four of the white. So there's two. Three. And again, this very last one is that slip stitch. We're not going to go in that. This is number four. Again, one black. So through the actual stitches. I mean, truthfully, if you went through part of the slip stitch instead of the black regular stitch, you really wouldn't know the difference. Again, now it's reversed, so we have the fatter part at the bottom, and we actually are ignoring the first slip stitch. In the top, we're going to count the one on the far left as a stitch. We need to get those three whites in. So here's number three. So you are pushing under the slip stitch on the top. Again, it's angled just a little bit off and it's tighter. Now the black. And we do have a white loose band here. I've come around to my loose band. Yours might be just a little bit in a different spot than mine. So I am going to attach it through the white. So for right now, I am going to go under this first part, this first slip stitch, since this is the smaller of the hexagon. So that's one. Two. I know it's a little tough where your loose band is. Here's three. And then what I'm going to do is to actually pick up this loose band. And then I'm going to go through the part where the loose band was attached to the previous row here. I'm going to go through that and then push up. I just don't want there to be a hole there. I know it's a little bit awkward. So I am pulling through that loose band there as well. And one through the other two. So now I'm onto the black. And this time I have the smaller part on the top, so I'm ignoring the first slip stitch. This is this section where we have three. So here's two. And again, third one is going in the slip stitch above. Now black. And I'm not going to go the whole way around because I am going to have to leave a little bit of space to add the stuffing and to flip it the right side out. So smaller part is at the bottom, so you do want to go through that slip stitch. If you feel like your hook is getting hung up, if you pull down on the main section as you're pulling through, it should help your hook. Makes a little bit of a larger opening for your hook to slide through. So that's three and four. And onto black. And I'm going to do a couple more sections here. So ignore the slip stitch in the white. That's one. Two. And you do want to go on the slip stitch on the top. Black, and then bottom, you are going through the slip stitch on the bottom. So here's number three. And number four, I think I will, let me see, definitely I'm going to do the black, and let me just stop right here. I'll attach my clip, and then I'm going to very carefully turn this right side out. So you want to try to do your best not to really stretch and pull it, but there's definitely going to be some stretching involved. So you're just flipping it the right side out. And then before we close it all off, we have to add the stuffing. So I like to use smaller pieces at a time when I add the stuffing. And you definitely want to make it nice and full. You want it to be nice and firm. Make sure that it gets packed in all of the edges. I mean, I guess there's not technically edges, but get it really packed in on the opposite side first and then the top and bottom. I mean, you don't want to make it so full that it's making the stitches bulge out and you can see the stuffing, but you definitely need to get it nice and firm. So, as I said, get it in and really work it, push it down nice and tight, and then just slowly work your way to where the gap is. Once you have your ball packed nice and firmly, you're ready to finish closing it off, and it's going to be a little bit more difficult this time because now we've flipped it right side out, so we're going to have to try and get the stitches to close this off but to still continue to look the same as it was when we were doing it on the opposite side. So your clip is going to be stuck on the inside here. You're going to have to reach in there and find it. And you just want to make sure you get that loose band back on your hook. Try not to get all the stuffing inside, which I already am doing. So let me just try and get that stuffing out of the way. Get this on my hook. Make sure you don't lose it. You don't want it coming apart. And take out my clip. So here's the way I'm going to show you how to do this. It's a little bit tricky, but I think you'll be able to do okay with it. You have your loose band on your hook. Now we're doing white next. So I am ignoring the first slip stitch. I'm going to go on the left-hand side first. I'm going to push through. I'm going to take a white band. I'm going to pull through the stitch. I'm going to pull through the band on my hook. So now I just need to make sure I don't let this go from my fingers. I'm going to angle the ball this way, hold the loop that's on my hook, hold that in my fingers. I'm going to go push through the white on this side, grab the part that's in my fingers on the left, pull that down through, and then one through the other. So what that has done is the same thing we were doing. It's pulling the band straight across and it's coming down through the sides, and we're still keeping that loose band on the inside. Hopefully everybody got that. Next one, going through the left-hand side first. Pull through the white, leave it in your fingers. And then I'm going to just pull through the one that's on my hook. Now leave this on your hook. So you have to stretch the band a little bit. We're just pushing up through the next white stitch. Grab it. It's going to come down through and through everything. Just really be careful not to lose this off your hook. Next one, again, we have white. Pull through everything. Leave it on your hook. If you're afraid that you're going to lose this, you could always put a clip on it just for safekeeping. And then hold this band back. Now here was our slip stitch. So this one's going to be tight. We're going to have to push through that. It's even harder because my hands are preoccupied here. I need like an extra hand here. I grabbed that by accident. Make sure you don't lose it, that's all. So through the slip stitch, then the band is going to pull through everything. Again, sometimes, especially with that slip stitch, it's so tight, gives you extra grief there. So now we're onto the black. Push through the stitch, grab your black band, pull through everything on your hook. Don't lose it. Hold this back. Slip through the black. Now you can grab it, and this comes through everything. See, it's keeping that nice, smooth, consistent look. You're not seeing the opposite end is still staying on the inside where you're doing the looping. So now I have three of the white. So this is the smaller side. Actually, I should have four of the white. Oh, this one got a little bit out of the picture here. So I am going through the slip stitch. It's a little bit easier this time because I have my hand is loose right now. Pull through everything. Other side. Push out through. Grab. Pull down through everything. Left side, band comes through all, hold everything, push out through, band comes through everything. We're going to do this two more times, through everything, push out through the right, this comes down through all. And one more time, everything. Push that through. And then this comes through everything. So we are going to have to close this off. We're back to black, so I'm going to take my additional band is going to be black. And I'm going to push up through here. Pull through everything on my hook. Make a nice and tight slip knot. And then it looks like there's a little bit more of a gap. I think I'm going to reach up through here. Pull this band down inside. I'm going to try and put it to where the gap is. If you do feel like there's any larger gaps, you can always take any additional bands and you can just make slip knots and tie it off. So I think I might have made the stuffing a little bit full. You can sort of see the stuffing in between the stitches a little bit more. But you can always shift the stuffing on the inside too if you feel like one side looks like it's pushed a little bit more. But as I said, you do want it nice and firm. And then your soccer ball is complete. I hope that everyone has a lot of fun playing with their new Lumigurumi soccer balls. You can always leave me comments on YouTube and Facebook. You can post pictures of your creations to my Facebook page. And please feel free to subscribe to my YouTube channel, so that way you can stay up to date when I have new tutorials available. You can also find me on Pinterest and Instagram, so please feel free to subscribe to those as well. Leave your pictures and comments there too. And if you do post on Instagram, don't forget to tag me. Thanks for watching!